Just got back from math and I passed the quiz. I made one like somewhat dumb mistake. So you can only miss one round, and then I was going on time. I was going back and forth between the answer, and then I was about to switch my answer because I thought the other one was correct, and it timed out, and it turned out the one that I was going to change from was correct. So I got really lucky, but it's sweet. I don't need to take that question on the exam. And then I also, the personhood class today was canceled, so I'll be heading back in, get some homework done, maybe finishing my D&D character. That'll be fun.
To the city far away. Hallelujah, 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 I am.
Super tired the past couple of nights. I've been able to fall asleep, but I haven't been able to like sleep well. Like I feel I'm half awake when I'm sleeping, like just, I don't know, like daydreaming. It's not like I'm having dreams because I am consciously thinking about things, but I don't know. So my hopes is I could take a nap and hopefully recuperate a bit before jazz band in an hour and a half. Alright, I was able to successfully take a nap, feel a lot better, and I'm rendering my model right now, and it's taking forever compared to David, who started after me, and he's almost past me. Alright, just finished jazz ensemble, and I was going to rush to eat dinner before I headed to EYS Engineering Your Soul, but I'm not very hungry because I ate a bit of a bagel while I had my ibuprofen before my nap, so I think I'm just going to finish that bagel, maybe have a banana afterward, and not rush to dinner, even though this is the only time really I could go.
Beyond even habits, life is made up of individual days.
Yeah, that's the obvious. You guys are smarter than me, Gonzalo.
After all, like adding to what they, with whoever just said that right now, each day is unique. So it's very rare that we're gonna have to get up with
the day. You guys familiar with the Andy Dover quote that talks about this? You guys know that's a famous quote. Have you heard it before? It's one worth really chewing on. How we spend our days is of course how we spend our lives. I don't know, maybe it's being 58, I don't know that I've read a more staggering quote. How you spend your days is how you spend your lives. And I wouldn't ask, what's the big deal? It's just our life. You never ask that, right? Said, no, it's a big deal. How's the lives matters? Well, that ties it together, doesn't it? And here's what I wanted to say about this, which I know is obvious, which is bringing the book. But this is what struck me.
I'm a person, no. Baby, my love unconditional. It's about more than material.
I just got back. Oh wow, I didn't realize how my hair, put it in different gel today, and I'm not sure how I like the look, but it definitely keeps the hair out of my face. Just got back from engineering, and we're all set. We're making drawings now of every single part. I'm printing it out, and bring it in to meet with Steve, who will spend half an hour meeting with us, going over stuff we have to do, and then we go back, make fixes, and turn it in to him, and he either approves us, denies us, whatever. And it's going to go good. I'm going to grind through it right now. I think that's what I'm going to do right now. And whatever I don't finish tomorrow, so then I can meet with him Thursday and hopefully make some changes and then turn it into him. So then that weekend and those days I can start building my engine. Alright, gonna go eat some lunch, taking a brain break. I've spent 3 hours working on my drawings and I've only got 3 parts done. But it's getting faster. Alright, another 2 hours logged in for these drawings. This is probably my least favorite part of the process thus far, but it's necessary and it'll help my manufacturing process be a lot quicker. I'm heading to a later dinner right now, hoping that there's not too much of a line because it is later. And then this food should be able to last me the rest of the night. Oh, I am so tired. Alright, I am pretty much completely done with all my drawings. I'll show you guys when I get back. I've got a couple more. I've got 15 minutes left. But we're out of chocolate milk, and I think tonight would be a good time to go to Fred Meyer, quickly grab it. But rather than other times, and I don't want to miss it when it closes at 11. So I'm going to quickly go do that. Pretty good. Alright, I'm back. And I'm gonna show you what I got done. Come over here and add one more hour with, I think 7 hours might be a bit of an exaggeration. It might be just 6. I'll keep it at 6. 6 hours worth of... No. This is all I worked on today. 7.5. On all my components. Okay, so if we go to the very front. This is... Actually, 1 minute. Let me start this over horizontally. Alright, so this is my cover page with it in isometric. This is it then in orthographic, top, front, and right. And this is exploded with a bill of materials, which took up majority of the space. Adjust this so it's not in the way. I want to figure out how, because this is a 11 by 17, I want to figure out how I could print this on paper somewhere in the school. So then this is the dimension drawing of my valve mount. This is of the base plate. And again, because this is being laser cut, I have what's being laser cut, and then these dimensions here are what I'm then going to have to machine, which is why it actually looks rather nice, because otherwise you can imagine how dimensioning all this would be incredibly hard. Alright, this is the sliding valve plate. This is the components of my piston cylinder. This is the actual piston assembly. These are my crankshafts and the weight in my flywheel. Here are my support pieces. Here's side of my flywheel and then on my crank discs. And lastly, these are my intake switch mechanisms. 7.5 hours of work today, Zaid. Pretty fun. Now I gotta figure out how to print these out and then go to my meeting with Steve, and hopefully he approves my drawings then on Thursday. Also, because I can't seem to be able to fall asleep these nights, there's no point in going to bed before 12 until I get some medicine to help me fall asleep. But I don't have much homework. I mean, I do have homework. Let me look. Yeah, I don't have... I have some stuff I could do tonight, but I think I'm gonna reward myself and watch an episode of What If, because I've already seen what, like, the 7th and 8th one are about, and oh, holy cow, they're so good. I'm only on 3, but I really want to get there fast, so I'm gonna watch 3 tonight. David, no, not with David, but maybe with Caswell and Tristan if he gets back. And we'll try getting in bed at 11 again. And I'm done with my drawings, but I'm really nervous about tomorrow. I hope they go well. I don't know what I'll do. I could redesign it so it is just machined, but I'm not sure. Alright. Slept in till 8:30 today because engineering class didn't happen because he wanted to give us time to work on our drawings and catch up. And I'm going to do a little bit more of that. Still not feeling so great. Got this terrible cough now, but what am I going to do? Heading to my meeting with Steve, and I'm like really nervous. My whole, like, I don't know, I'm just really nervous. I have my drawings printed out. We'll take notes. And I think I'm gonna record it on my phone. I don't know. All right, just had my talk and he definitely gave me some improvements to my design that I'm going to implement now. But it's not going to work. I'm going to try really hard to get it to work, and I'll be so happy with myself if I can get it to work, but I don't know. Yeah, kind of knocked me down a couple notches. I'm pretty worried. Shows you how flustered I was that I left my backpack and coat and computer and all my stuff at Steve's office, and I came back for it an hour later. That's how long it took me to realize. I mean, I went to lunch, but still, man, I really gotta think this through. I did some work, and I'm not as overwhelmed, but still a bit worried. I took out a good chunk of complexities that I added that aren't necessary, so now it's just single acting, not dual acting, and I don't have a switcher now for switching between dual and single. Heading to Maker Hub now. And moment of truth, I'm gonna measure how much the acrylic is, its width, and how inaccurate it is. Hey. All right. This is the Hoedown. Hello. 1 minute. Yeah. I think it would be more up my alley because, I don't know. I don't know if I want to go out there when I get homework done or do something else. You know, I am going to go change. I'm going to go do that. This is the closest thing I have to a flannel, making use of what I got for, not homecoming, what was it, for the 80s dance. And I'm going to go see if I can find anyone and maybe do some nice fun line dancing.
No problem.
Got done with the Hoedown. That was pretty fun. Got some line dancing, got some swing dancing in. And what I didn't realize is when I was working out by Injid, I missed dinner. And I didn't realize I missed dinner until I got to the Hoedown. I'm like, shoot, I missed dinner. I'm not very hungry, but I ate a donut and a cupcake. And now my stomach really doesn't feel so good. All the sugar and that exercise. But yeah, it's pretty fun. Well, I was really bummed because Mark, or the swing dance guy, took Julia and started, everyone was cheering around him and he was doing all these dips. And I mean, he was doing this, he ended on this cool dip and everyone applauded. And I'm like, shoot. I really want to do that with Julia because we just worked on this even crazier dip. The one where she nearly drops to the ground twice. But we tried, but we never got the opportunity where we were swing dancing and everybody was watching. But it was still a lot of fun. And I don't know what I'm going to eat. Maybe a couple oranges, a banana. I'm not sure. Got some math homework and personhood homework to finish. Alright, heading to the Maker Hub again. Got maybe hour and a half worth of engine design, fixing that up. And now I'm gonna go laser cut some more parts.
Hey, and some piano, please.
Sure, if I did that, I had a jazz performance for an hour before the homecoming parade thing, so that was pretty fun. Got some good solos in. I forgot to record, but I just went for, David wanted me to, so I went for 15 minutes to go watch the homecoming football game, and it was pretty cool. We're winning. College students being college students, and being like high schoolers being really loud and sometimes obnoxious. Yeah. We also have a ton of cheerleaders. Well, we have like the abnormally large cheerleading squad, and then we also have the same amount of people in dance squad, so like it's a ton of students doing that. I'm gonna go see if I could get into Edwards Holman to see if I could pick up my drawings or not. I'm not sure. I might do a loop around it to see if there's any unlocked buildings. Nope, no luck. Gonna go see if I could start making my piston machine that. All right. Finally picked out my outfit for the electro swing dance. It's supposed to be colorful. I don't have anything colorful, but this is what looked best with this purple vest.
Spin you. And now come in. Spin you this way. And now we come closed. Watch you away.
Alright, had some fun swing dancing, learned some new moves that I think, if I remember to, will be included in the video. If I show you down here, here's all the parts to my engine. I messed up, but I think I could fix it, but here are my components. Yeah, all good stuff. One more thing I forgot to say is that, one thing that came to mind is I need to start doing push-ups and stuff because I'm barely strong enough to do some of the new moves, and if possible, I want to be able to do it, and that might be motivation enough to get me to start working out. I don't know. But the thing was, I wanted to say was, apparently, John Krasinski, the office guy, or something, actor, and Emily Blunt, I think that's her name, were filming, oh god, excuse me, we're filming A Quiet Place 3 in Newburgh today. Like, that's absolutely insane. And like, the school invited them to come see our homecoming football game. Obviously they had better things to do, but still, that's insane. Like, if there's clips in that movie and I'm like, I went to that coffee shop with my professor during college, and then oh, it just got destroyed by an alien. Like, that would be hilarious. I've had this cough and it's so annoying. Alright. It is 10:30. I will tonight finish my reading and watch some videos so I can write my essay tomorrow. Heading to Grace Baptist now. I was going to longboard there. Couldn't find anyone who wanted to go with me because they're all, I don't want to knock on doors if they're trying to sleep, but it's raining outside, so I'm just gonna drive, knock on the lawn board, maybe another time. just got done machining a lot of these parts. Went to the laser cutter, got some more things done. I'm a little more confident. I just really hope it works. I know it will not be good, but I just hope it works.